Good day and welcome back to TMac FPV, your home for your journey to better FPV, fun flights, and racing stuff. Today, I'm going to show you how to go from this.
Welcome to OpenTX.
To something like this.
Welcome to OpenTX.
And from this. To something like this. In just four simple steps and a few short minutes. I mean, the T16's got a 480 by 272 color screen, why not use it, right? Let's go!
To begin with, all of these screen images are located on your T16's SD card, which I have taken out from my T16 and inserted into a micro SD to USB adapter and plugged that into my computer. You can do the same thing basically with a USB to mini USB cable attached to your T16 and the computer. I choose to do it by taking the SD card out of my transmitter. This is a file directory of your SD card using OpenTX. We're going to be using the folder images for both your splash screen, which is the screen you see when you turn on the T16, and also your models images. For your background image, if you choose to customize that, you'll need the themes folder here and the subfolder default. For each of these images, the type of image, the folder location on your SD card, the file type, and the max pixel size, and the file name that you need to name it are depicted here. For your model image, you can name it anything you want as long as it's six characters in length. So all you need to do is find an image you want to use for, let's say, your splash screen. And for my splash screen, I'm going to use my TMac FPV logo for that. Make sure it's a PNG file type, and I can do that by right-clicking on it, go to Properties and Details, and over here, you can see that the file type is PNG, and you can see the pixel size here is 791 by 836 pixels. So I need to resize my TMac FPV logo to use it as a splash screen. There are different ways to do that, and I like to use a site called resizeimage.net. Just go to resizeimage.net, upload the image that you want. I'm going to use my TMac FPV logo image. And it uploads it, and it shows you what the pixel size is. Then just type in the pixel size that you want to use. And if I type in 480, and we want 480 by 7272 max, but it comes out to be 480 by 507. So I want my smallest pixel size to be 272, and that makes it 257 by 272, which is still okay. The 480 by 272 is the max size. I wanted to keep the same aspect ratio so it doesn't distort the image. And then you just click on Resize Image, and you can view the image. There it is. Download the image. I'm just going to paste it in the same folder over here. If we go back to this chart for our splash screen, we need to make sure and name it Splash. So that's what I'll name my resized TMac FPV logo. I'll rename this Splash. And there it is. We want to make sure it's still a PNG file, which it is. And then all we need to do is take this, copy it, and stick it in our folder, which was image folder. And there it is. And there's our image. Once our new image named Splash is on our SD card and the SD card is in our jumper T16, we should now just be able to turn on our T16 and the new splash screen should appear, like this.
Welcome to OpenTX.
And we would use the exact same process to create a custom model image with three exceptions. The pixel size of the model image needs to be 192 by 114. And we can name our model anything we would like as long as it's six characters max. And the file type can be PNG or JPG. To demonstrate a custom model image, I'll go back to our T16 custom images folder. And I'm going to select this one for my HDLRC Aero 3 hybrid. We'll take a look at the details on this. It is a PNG file, as we can see here, which is good. The dimensions of it, however, are 382 by 383, which is not what we need. We need a max of 192 by 114. So we're going to have to use our resize image for this one. Go back to our resizeimage.net, upload the image. There it is, 382 by 383. We want 192 by 193 is what it shows up as. That's not going to be good. We want 114 as our minimum size. So in this case, it's going to be 114 by 114. PNG, resize image, view image. There it is. Download the image. And we're going to grab that and stick it in our folder. Paste it in our folder. Here it is. And once again, we can rename it anything we want as long as it's six characters. And let's name it Arrow 3. Now for our model image, we put it under the same folder as we did for our splash screen, which is our images folder, and paste that into our images folder. Paste. And here it is down here, Arrow 3, PNG. Click on that. There it is. Now to change our background image, we just use the exact same procedure as we just did for the splash image and also the custom model image, except we need to name it background. And we also save it to a different folder, this time the themes default folder. So let's go back to our custom images folder. And the splash image I'm going to be using is here. And this was actually obtained from a gentleman named Fabio. And I'll put the link to his site, which has several background images which you can use. I'll put his link down in the video description below. And thank you, Fabio, for making this available to all of us. The background image needs to be a max size of 480 by 272, and the images on Fabio's site that I've been able to take a look at are already 480 by 272, so we don't need to use our resizeimage.net on these. We do want to rename the image background, so I'm going to rename this background. We need to place it under themes and default. Now before we put the new background custom image in our folder, we notice that we've already got this file, which is the Jumper T16 background on here. So if we want to save this image, and there's no reason not to, what I'm going to do is I'm going to rename this old background, OLD, underline, background. And that way it's just saved in the same place. And what we can do now is go back to our new custom background image and copy and paste that to the same folder. So now we have a new background PNG file, 480 by 272 in dimensions, on our SD card. So we've got the background on our SD card. We've got our model image, Arrow 3, on the SD card. And we've got splash image, TMac FPV logo, on our SD card. So now all we have to do is put our SD card in the transmitter and turn it on.
Welcome to OpenTX.
And there we have both our TMac FPV logo on our splash screen and also our new background. What we don't have here yet is our custom model image, so let's go ahead and do that now. Go to our model setup. On the first page, we scroll down to model image, click and hold enter. And we just want to scroll down to our new custom model image, which is Arrow 3. Hit return. And there she is. So now we've got our new custom splash screen, which in my case is our TMac FPV logo. We've got our new background image. And we've got our bloody Arrow 3 hybrid custom model image. And we're good to go. Make sure to like the video, share it with your friends, subscribe to your TMac FPV channel. Thank you for your time. We'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.